Hey everybody, it's me, Maggie No, host of the Maggie No Show, No Brain Edition. And today I've got a deep, emotional story. One never explored before. Hopefully you learned something new today about me, about yourself, and about what you can achieve when you put your mind to it. What is it? We don't know. I guess you'll know in a few minutes. Actually, a few seconds, once this actually starts rolling. I know you guys are probably like, end the intro, and I'm gonna skip forward. Don't skip forward, just wait for me to end the intro, okay? End scene. Okay, enjoy. So, this is a story of passion. It's a story of a road not taken, a life not lived. And I guess we should begin with when I was a little kid, a wee little child. I learned how to somersault insanely fast. I was the fastest somersaulter to ever live. And when I say kid, I mean I started when I was in elementary school until I was about 16, 17 years old, a sophomore in high school. And I've retired now, settled down under a peaceful public bridge in my old age. But if you ask me, I'd throw a somersault down so fast, that you wouldn't even realize. You would only know because an energy shifted in the universe. I had crossed time in such a fast motion that something changed. Also, I'd probably throw out my back. I'm just kidding. That's dramatic. I'm not really that old. I'm 19. But it's a patented technique that I use to somersault. And I wasn't always this way, okay? I wasn't always as fast of a somersaulter. I remember I went to Woodstock Day Camp. And for the talent show, I had to do something. I wanted to. And I didn't know what to do. What could I do? And one of the grown women at this camp, I don't know what her role was. I don't think she was a counselor. She was a little too old for that. But she wanted to help me cultivate my passion. And we say, okay, what can Maggie do? What can she do? Well, can she do a cartwheel? No, she can't. Can she sing? Definitely not. Maybe she should do stand-up comedy. No. No, this woman's the definition of unfunny. So the last thing on the list was somersaulting. Anybody can somersault. So for days on end with this grown woman from the camp who had been assigned to develop and cultivate my personality, my skills, I would somersault in front of her back and forth. And these somersaults were so slow, so sad and so slow. And this lady, she would lie to my face. She would tell me my somersaults were good and they sucked. And I knew it. I knew it. And that year, I didn't do my somersaults in front of everybody because I was embarrassed. It took me decades to get across from one stage to the next. Also, you know, you gotta come prepared. Like, if I wore a skirt to camp that day, there was no somersaulting. It was setting me back. So I started to train and develop my own technique, my patented technique. And in a regular somersault, you roll up into a little ball and you roll. But for this Maggie somersault, it was more of I jump, tuck my head, and roll. I'm moving at such high speeds that I actually fling myself up again. And that's how you get the speed. And I never feel as euphoric as I do when I am jumping at high speeds, considering it a somersault. There's no freer feeling. And it's really not a somersault. It's an exaggerated somersault, I would say. But anyway, people started noticing. Like, people started noticing that I had this skill. And it's really difficult to keep a skill like this under wraps for too long. Because eventually, people find your secret and want to exploit you. And my friends, they I would somersault. We would have somersaulting races. I would just somersault for fun. And they would cheer me on and say, oh my God, Maggie, how do you somersault so fast? And we would race and I would just destroy them. Like, I'd be rolls ahead of them. They barely started when I've already finished. And one time I rolled so hard that my nose started to bleed. My nose started to bleed because I shook my brain too much. And looking back at this, the fast rolling, my friends cheering me on, the brain damage, I have to confess, I loved that people thought that I was a fast somersaulter. I got high off the praise people would say to me and telling me, Maggie, you're such a fast somersaulter. You're so good. Oh my God, how do you do that? They would just load me with compliments. And I would just be like, oh, I'm the king of the world. And I can't help but be like, why? Why did I feel this way? It literally does not matter at all. It matters so little. So little. I mean, I'm also kind of like a nihilist and nothing really matters. But this is definitely on the bottom of the totem pole if things did matter. It's like, oh, great. You're a fast somersaulter. So where are you going to college? Oh, perfect. You're a fast somersaulter. When are you going to start paying your mortgage and providing for your family? Like, it doesn't help with any of that. Yet when I somersault and I hear my name or some variation of my name, because it's really hard to hear when you're somersaulting, especially at such high speeds, I am in a state of complete euphoria. And there is no greater high than when you win that race and you hear that crowd of 9 and 10 year olds chanting your name, Maggie, 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 like you are an Olympian. And every night I go to bed and I dream about this. Nobody appreciates it as much anymore, but I can still hear it. And like I said, I can't hear it that well because I've got some brain damage from all that somersaulting, but I do feel it. And all I want to do is somersault and just be one with the universe. Again, a super dramatic story, but I think it really spoke to who I was and who I am now. So you've definitely learned something about me. Thanks for listening.